Hello dear students, in this video we will study some topics of class 10th chapter Human Eye and the Colorful World. We will discuss about atmospheric refraction and scattering of light. Since in the last chapter light, we studied about refraction. And refraction means the bending of light whenever there is change in the medium. Similarly, atmospheric refraction can be defined as the refraction of light caused by the Earth's atmosphere. As we all know that in atmosphere we have different layers, and in each layer we have different optical densities. So whenever the light is passed from one medium to another, it always undergoes some refraction. क्योंकि जो अर्थ की लेयर्स हैं, अगर बहुत गर्मी है तो हमारे पास जो अर्थ की लेयर्स हैं डिफरेंट नियर द सर्फेस, they become very hot and hot air becomes lighter, which means that the layers near the earth will be rarer and as we move above it becomes denser. But this is not the case every time. Generally we have the layers near the surface of earth as denser and as you move above they become rarer. A very simple example is, kabhi agar aapne dekha ho, hum agar aag jalaye तो आग के आसपास वाली एयर जो है वो लाइट हो जाती है, यानी रेयरर मीडियम बन जाता है, और उससे थोड़ा सा ऊपर डेंसर मीडियम बन जाता है. एंड यू कैन ऑब्जर्व द फ्लिकरिंग ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स और ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर वेन एवर वी ऑब्जर्व इट थ्रू द बर्निंग लेयर्स ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर. द फर्स्ट वेरी कॉमन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एटमॉस्फेरिक रिफ्रैक्शन इज ट्विंकलिंग ऑफ स्टार्स. द अपेरेंट पोजिशन ऑफ द स्टार्स इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द एक्चुअल पोजिशन ऑफ द स्टार्स. And since they are far away from us, they appear to be twinkling. Now, what is the reason? As you can see, during night, the layers near the Earth's atmosphere, near the Earth's surface, are having a higher refractive index. Yani ye jo niche wala surface hai, ye ek denser medium hai. And as you move above, we have different layers and they are rarer. So, when the star or the light coming from the star moves from rarer to denser, it appears to be bending towards the normal. As you can see, ये हमने एक normal बनाया है और जो ray सीधी जानी चाहिए थी वो bend हो गई towards the normal. Again at a different layer, ये अब rarer medium बन जाएगा और उससे नीचे वाला denser medium बन जाएगा. Again the ray will bend towards the normal. And if we extend it backwards, you can see this dotted line. The star appears to be at this position. यानी जो इसकी position है वो थोड़ी सी shift हो गई है. So there is a apparent shift in the position of the star. And also the temperature of the Earth's layers keeps changing. जिसकी वजह से stars जो हैं वो अपनी position shift करते रहते हैं. So there is twinkling also of the stars due to atmospheric refraction. Second example of atmospheric refraction is advanced sunrise and delayed sunset. The sun is visible to us about 2 minutes before sunrise and 2 minutes after sunset. इसका मतलब है total 4 minutes का difference है due to the atmospheric refraction. Now as you can see in this diagram, the actual position of sun is over here before the sunrise. But due to the difference in the optical densities of the Earth's atmosphere, which means कि जो हायर एटमॉस्फेयर में लेयर्स हैं उनका रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स कम है, यानी वो रेयरर हैं, और जो क्लोज टू द अर्थ सरफेस हैं वो डेंसर हैं, यानी उनका रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ज़्यादा है. नाउ एज द रे वी ड्रॉ अ नॉर्मल एंड द रे गोइंग फ्रॉम रेयरर टू डेंसर बेंड्स टुवर्ड्स द नॉर्मल. अगेन एट दिस पॉइंट इट बेंड्स टुवर्ड्स द नॉर्मल. एंड इफ वी ऑब्जर्व देन यू कैन ड्रॉ दिस डॉटेड लाइन एंड सी कि ऐसा लगता है दैट द सन इज एट दिस पॉइंट. यानी सन अभी राइज नहीं किया, बट ऐसा लगता है दैट देयर इज सनराइज. एंड सिमिलर इज ड्यूरिंग द सनसेट ऑल्सो. सो ड्यू टू द एटमॉस्फेरिक रिफ्रैक्शन द रेज बेंड स्लाइटली टुवर्ड द नॉर्मल एट ईच रिफ्रैक्शन एज यू कैन सी, एंड दे आर अपीयर टू बी कमिंग फ्रॉम अ डिफरेंट पोजिशन. एंड हेंस द सन अपीयर्स टू राइज अ फ्यू मिनट्स बिफोर द एक्चुअल सनराइज एंड सिमिलरली अपीयर्स टू बी at a position even after it has been actually set. Next topic is scattering of light. Now, scattering of light is defined as the change in the path of light when it strikes any obstacle. For example, as you can see in this picture, the path of the light is visible when it strikes the dust particles present in the Earth's atmosphere or the air particles. Scattering of light can also be termed as Tyndall effect because the Earth's atmosphere is a heterogeneous mixture of minute particles. The particles could be dust particles, particles of sulfur, nitrogen, etc. And whenever a beam of light strikes these particles, the path of light becomes visible. You can see when you open your windows and the light enters, you can see those fine dust particles. A very common phenomenon. Similarly, scattering of light helps in explaining some more phenomena like the blue color of the sky, why the clouds are white, and why the sun appears to be red during sunrise and sunset, and why the danger signals are always red. These all can be explained with the help of Rayleigh scattering. So let us discuss Rayleigh scattering. Rayleigh scattering is possible when the particles are having size much smaller than the wavelength of the light radiation. And the scattering is more dominant when the intensity is proportional to the fourth power of the wavelength. जिसका मतलब है जिनकी wavelength कम होगी वो ज़्यादा scatter होंगे as compared to the light having a longer wavelength. The air molecules, that is nitrogen and oxygen molecules, are having the right size which can effectively scatter the shorter wavelengths. Now you know that in case of white light, which means wo light jo sun se hamari taraf aa rahi hai, it consists of 7 colors, vibgyor. And out of all these, we know that the wavelength of violet is the least. यानी ये जो वायलेट इंडिगो और ब्लू हैं इनकी वेवलेंथ सबसे कम है एज कम्पेयर टू रेड ऑरेंज और येलो सो वी कैन एक्सप्लेन सिंस द इंटेंसिटी वेरीज विद द फोर्थ पावर ऑफ द वेवलेंथ इनवर्सली एंड आउट ऑफ ऑल द कलर्स विबग्योर द ब्लू कलर इज हैविंग द लीस्ट वेवलेंथ सिंस आर आई इज सेंसिटिव टू ब्लू कलर एंड नॉट टू वायलेट एंड इंडिगो तो हमें आसमान नीला नजर आता है because it scatters the most and the red color is having the maximum wavelength so its intensity of scattering is the least to jo red color hai it scatters the least that is why the danger signals are always red isliye hamesha danger signals red banaye jate hain taki wo na bikhre aur hame dur se bhi nazar aaye and similar is the reason of the sun appearing to be red during the sunrise and sunset as the distance of the horizon agar sun sunset ke time ya sunrise ke time hum dekh rahe hain to jo distance of the horizon hai that is less as compared to the distance when it is overhead aur wo color jo dur se bhi bikhrta nahi hai wo hai red isliye hame sun jo hai sunrise aur sunset ke time red dikhta hai now one question for you Why clouds are always white? You can answer this on the basis of scattering of light. Okay, thank you.